I'm Sheila Mireyes from Grade 8C.
And I'm Via Naisha Algorico from 8C as well. And our group will discuss to you how to properly do back and front flow.
Also, we are going to teach you how to do back light and so on.
Now we will demonstrate how to do the back glide. Back glide is actually pretty easy and can be done by many people. First, grab on the railings. If there is no railings, grab onto the swimming pool's grid. Second, we tuck the legs and both of the feet are stepping on the pool's wall. Always remember that the shoulders are touching the ears and the arms are over the head. Lastly, exert force when pushing the feet off the wall. The goal here is to have the face remain above the water, not under the water.
So now I will teach you how to do front float with flutter kick. But first, how to do front float. You should basically lie on the water with your face facing the ground of the pool so that you would look like you are lying on the surface of the water. Next, you should relax your muscles, your body, so that you would be less tense. After that, you should be trying to be stable at this position for a few seconds. Now you have done front float. Next, flutter kick. You should just paddle your feet in a proper way so that you would move along the water. Now we will mix them together. You should put your hands above your head, tuck behind your ears so that you would have your imaginary center line. After that, you would have a head start with a kick in the wall of the pool so that you would have force going through the water. Now the objective here is to stay at the surface of the water, or if you want, you can go under, but it is better to stay in the surface and do your flutter kick, do your float, and now you know how to do the front float plus flutter kick.
Now it's time for back float and flutter kick. So basically, this is just the same as the front float with flutter kick. It's just that you will be facing the sky while you are swimming, but still your hands still above your head, tucked behind your ears.
Now let's move on to our last swimming objective, which is the backstroke. The backstroke is pretty hard to do, but with the right practice and timing, you're good to go. Now, let's demonstrate how to do it. Before you try the backstroke on the swimming pool, first, do the exercise when doing the backstroke. Do it on a dry platform standing up. Do this on the right arm. First, use the pinky finger in going in. Second, scoop. Third, straight arm. Then lastly, the thumb will the last to go out. Then switch. After doing this many times and doing it on the water, you are good to go. A step-by-step procedure on the water. First, use the pinky finger in going in. Second, scoop. Third, straight arm. And lastly, thumb will be the last to go out. Then switch.